Then I mentioned I was on my way to the Institute for Advanced Study in Princeton. I stopped off to see my parents and pick up my ancient Morris Minor convertible, which I drove from Rochester to Princeton. And the top of the convertible was not entirely secure, so it let in a lot of road dust and things. I got to Princeton maybe 2 or 3 in the afternoon, and all I wanted to do was to get the key to my condo and go there and have a bath. This was my object. But the key to the condo was in the administrative offices. So I went in there, and I said who I was, and the secretary said, yes, Dr. Oppenheimer wants to speak to you. And I thought, there is no chance on this earth that Dr. Oppenheimer wants to speak to me. I don't want to speak to him because I'm covered in road dirt, and I just want to. So I said, well, it must be some error because, you know, there's no reason he wants to speak to you. Oh, yes, yes, he wants to speak to you. So I walked into Oppenheimer's office, and he was beautifully dressed. His clothes were all specially tailored by the only bespoke tailor in Princeton at Langrock, Mr. Decker. Mr. Decker was very pleased to be the bespoke tailor for Oppenheimer. And he had fabricated, among other things, a special green Loden coat, which Oppenheimer wore in the winter. So he was extremely well-dressed. He was rather wealthy, and he sort of liked having money, I believe. So the first thing that he said to me was, what is new and firm in physics? And this question completely threw me because I thought it might say what was new, but I wasn't sure it was firm. I could say what was firm, and I'd done some work this summer, it was firm, but it wasn't particularly new or very interesting. So I did not have any idea what to answer to this, and the phone rang. So I thought, oh God, I can get out of here because, you know, he doesn't want to answer the phone when I'm here. So he picked up the phone, began talking, and I said, he said, no, please stay, he said, and I stayed. And then he was talking, it was clear he was talking to his wife, Kitty, she was called, Katherine Kitty. So he hung up the phone, then he said to me, it's Kitty, and she's been drinking again. And I was absolutely appalled. I didn't know what to say or what to do. And years later, Robert Silvers, the editor of the New York Review of Books, told me that Oppenheimer did the same thing to him with Kitty. Absolutely appalling. So I was mute. And then he said, we have some pictures at our house you might like to see. I said, yes, well, thank you very much. I had no idea what he was talking about. Later on in the fall, I did go to his house for a party, and I realized that among the pictures were either one or two Van Goghs, and he had a collection which had been assembled by his father, a small but superb collection of pictures. One of the father's pictures, I think, belonged to his brother Frank, and was now in the Metropolitan, is actually one of my favorite Van Goghs. So that was my first introduction to Oppenheimer.